It's a few words about me. I'm a school support engineer with more than 10 years experience. I'm author of a book called My School Troubleshooting about a designed prototype of current JSON support of in MySQL. I'm author of some hobby projects and speaker on various conferences. So that's me. And today I will speak about optimizer histograms. And here is our agenda. I will tell about a little bit why I'm interesting. I think it's interesting feature and why it's useful feature. I will show you a couple of examples. Show what is how optimizer histograms. It depends from index statistics and a little bit about how MySQL histograms work. Before we start, I want to ask you, who here uses MySQL? Okay, who knows about index cardinality and index statistics? Okay, so currently MySQL versions up to 8.0 use only a way to tell optimizer which plan to choose is a statistic which is collected by storage engine. And histograms, we are all done on different level, like Lalit showed you MySQL architecture, like index statistic is collected on storage engine level and optimizer histogram is collected by optimizer itself. So why do I care? Why do I think about it could be useful? Issue for this, it's like about like two years of experience at Percona support. And I worked on like for 2 years with different customers, with different support tickets, but they have all the same pattern. So they have like kind of tables. And we have a data distribution, which is very, because like it's very easy to create a plan when data distribution, like it's the same, like if we store fruits, like it's like 1 million apples, 1 million oranges, 1 million pineapples. But if we have like 1 million apples and only 10 pineapples, we may have something which don't work as expected. Cardinality is sometimes not correct because cardinality is maintained by storage engine and it's not always maintained in time. And if table is big, it may take long time. And even if it's recalculated, sometimes people prefer to keep it more persistent because data consistency changes and still some delay. Statistics can be recalculated and then some changes happens with data and it still could be wrong. Index maintenance costs a lot because it's space on disk and every update you need to update index statistics. So that's actually it speed ups your selects and slow downs your inserts. Sometimes only the optimizer doesn't work as we wish to, even if index statistic is correct. I did a talk at Percona Live, and here is barcode, and also this is clickable link for slides which will be shared. And here is examples for my talk at Percona Live, and you will see more details. Here I want to add disclaimer. So this talk today is based on absolutely real support cases, some of them are still in progress. But all examples are 100% fake, so that's no customers could be identified. So all tests are generated, tables names, columns names, data, everything. Use case itself by its fiction. If you find any similarities, that's not true. That's at least it's not that customers which I served. It's probably your case is similar. All examples are simplified. So what does it mean? It doesn't mean we don't live in a world when our database is like in university book about normalization design. We have sometimes keep very 25 columns, some of them with text or large object data. We have sometimes like some extra data, maybe sometimes we over normalize, but nothing is evil. But here for this example, this adds complication and this adds hardness to for optimizer to create good query plan. But for clarity, I just removed all these things and only showed the relevant columns for my examples. And all disasters which I describe here, of course, happened in version 5.7 before histograms were introduced. Okay, so use case. First use case, it's like we have two tables. One is small, it's like call it categories, like for online shop. And the second one is quite big. It contains all goods which is in shop. It has many rows. We just like foreign key relationship, very fine, and many other fields like price, date, store where it's located, everything. And join, so we are joining goods with categories, on categories ID, category ID, which were added in some range. We are category ID in some, and we have some price and other condition, probably some other limits. So how can we resolve this query? Option first is select from the small table first, and for each category ID, select from the large table, and filter then result. And this this approach will work, but it will work very slow if we have many items in the category. Option two is filter rows by date or by condition. Get category ID values, retrieve all rows from the small table, but it will be slow if we have if small tables it's not really small, or if we have like a number of categories much larger than a number of goods in the selection. What if you combine indexes on category ID and all this condition? It resolves the issue, but I would not saying about this. We are not telling about this because I'm telling about like only features, because for more than 20 years of my school life, we learning how to deal with them. Issue here that index can be not useful for selecting rows, because in real life we do not have joined like two tables. We have like multiple joins, we have multiple conditions, group by, order by, limit, all these things. And then sometimes you just cannot create an index which can cover everything to make a proper plan and to make all these things. Table may have wrong cardinality just because we use it for too long. And here it's like for our example, let's check for explain. We ask for a large range for 1 year here, and we ask only for 10 rows. And optimizer by default selects from table category, which is small table. It's just very naive approach. And then it selects for large table. And please pay attention for this field. It's filtered, it means like how many rows were filtered from retrieved result cell. So like we are getting like 100 rows, and optimizer expect we will use only 11. Let's run this query and see it's like took 57 seconds. Here are it's engine statistics. These are status variable which increases each time when when storage engine performs operation. Now we are interested in read something, it also writes because it creates temporary table to resolve this query. Now let's add is the histogram. This is a syntax, it's analyze table, update histogram on a column. Explain with histogram, it's different. So first we have large table first. This same number rows as we asked for, and here is filtered. These are true numbers, so this is not 11. We are asking for 100 rows, and we take 98 rows. So this is real numbers which are recalculated. And then we just select single row from the small table. And the result is here, you see it's 56 divided by 0 times faster. How much is it? Okay. So this is engine statistics. Even worse case, what is like for this, it's actually quite easy. You can use straight join, you can find out how to optimize this. For this case, we have two tables, like one called good characteristics. It has pretty much nice long indexes. And second one is good shops. It also has pretty nice indexes. So like here we have ID, good ID, size of the good, manufacturer. And here we have location, delivery option, and it should be shop ID probably. Here are numbers, here 100 rows, 131,000 rows, and here is 65,000 rows. But here is what is data distribution. So this could be like, for example, take laptops, and here is like, this our shop doesn't like laptops with big screens. So we are just selling small screen laptops, just like a few of them. Companies, we have like pretty popular companies, but Sony stopped producing laptops, so we have only 10 laptops by Sony, and this is a local Turkish company, we just don't sell them in London. For shops, it's again, it could be same thing. So we have like pretty shops which have a lot of laptops, and Moscow, Kyiv shops, for example, they sell something else, not laptops. Delivery options, again, we have pretty, but premium urgent, it's again, it's not for laptops, it's for something else.